All right. Thank you guys so much for coming today to my mom's celebration of life party. My mom said she never wanted a traditional funeral. She wanted the biggest party you've ever seen in her honor. And I'm so glad we're able to provide that for her today. I'd like to share with you some reflections from a son's perspective about my mother, Patricia Ann Moberly. For as long as I can remember, both my brother and I have referred to her as my mother. Even when talking to one another, it wasn't our mother, our mom, it was my mother. I've been thinking all week, why would we do that, even when talking to one another? I think it's because in some strange way, we didn't want to share her. We wanted her all to ourselves. For those of you who don't know, my brother and I have always been fiercely competitive. In fact, I could sit here and name off all the things I'm so much better at than him. And now isn't the time or place for that. Seriously though, she was such a special woman. I know that I did not want to share her time or affection with anyone, especially a mean older brother. And I'm pretty positive he didn't want to share her either. Evidence of this comes in a story I've heard my mom and dad tell many times of how when I was just a baby, he begged them to throw me away in the trash can. What I've come to realize over the past week is that I never needed to compete for her affection. Her heart and her giving spirit was enormous, plenty big enough to go around. In fact, we've seen this over and over from the past week from stories so many of you here today that have been touched by her. And we all know you couldn't compare her tiny stature to her personality. Nothing was tiny about her personality. Her generosity was unmatched, but if you crossed her, it was just about a certainty you would hear an infamous string of dirty words that was so entertaining coming from such a small old woman. The most obvious examples to me of my mother's kind heart are bottled up in my experiences growing up. She was there for me every step of the way. She was there for me when I bawled my eyes out with the thought of stepping foot in Garden Springs Elementary for my first day of school. She was there painfully watching me struggle through my first baseball season. She helped me deal with my first broken heart, and she's given me honest, loving advice for as long as I can remember, even when I didn't want it. The not-so-obvious examples of her kindness were hidden deep in the depths of her soul that not many people knew about. No one, except my dad, talked to my mom more than I did. We've only missed talking a handful of days for as far back as I can remember. My mother took in family members and neighbors when they needed her and raised them as her own. She gave her time and resources to people who reached out to her, regardless of their background. But the example that hits home most to me about the kind of woman my mother was one that's very close to my heart, and I'd like to share that with you. As many of you know, my wife and I are proud parents of a new baby boy, Keegan. Back in September of last year, Sharon was in the hospital for 2 weeks with pregnancy complications. Our son had to be born 6 weeks early. He was put in the neonatal intensive care unit and stayed there for a couple more weeks. We finally got home. We were so excited, but naturally I would call my mom worrying about every scrape, every little cry, everything that didn't go exactly like I thought it should go. Finally, mom told me something I'll never forget. She said, stop worrying about all that stuff and just enjoy it. She told me that with her first pregnancy, she had a similar experience, but a very different outcome. She told me that when she was pregnant, they didn't have all the fancy high-tech monitoring equipment that they have today that they had for Keith. She told me that neither she nor the doctors knew of a complication with her pregnancy that compromised the umbilical cord of their unborn child. She told me that the baby did not survive birth. She told me, stop worrying and just enjoy him. Although I knew about her older sibling that had passed shortly after birth, my mom and I never talked about it, not in all those conversations over the last 30 plus years. In fact, to this day, I still don't know his name. Why? Was it because it was too hard for her to talk about, or was it because she wanted to make sure that that tragedy didn't affect how she wanted to raise us? I suspect it was both. I don't know about you, but I can't imagine how strong a woman you'd have to be to carry such a heavy burden and not let that negatively affect the rest of your entire life. Knowing what I know now as a father, I don't think I could. In addition to this, my mother lived with an unbelievably difficult set of medical circumstances over the past years, but you would have never known it from her attitude. And as many people have told me over the past few days that did not know my mom very well, your mom had to be a saint. She put up with your dad for all those years. My point is, no matter what happened to her, she was always there for her family and friends. In spite of the heavy burdens and unimaginable tragedies she faced in her life, she was always the most caring and giving woman you would ever meet. She was so strong, nothing could get her down or distract her from what she wanted in life. She shaped her circumstances. She did not let her circumstances shape her. In closing, I believe her legacy is a legacy of love of family and friends, a legacy of strength in the face of adversity, and a legacy of not letting life get you down. So, although I will always say my mother, now I fully understand she was not just mine. She was all of ours. And the best tribute we could possibly make to her is to live our lives just like we're doing today as a celebration.
How many times have I turned away? The number is the same as stand on the shore. Every time you've taken me back, now I pray you do it once more. Please take from me my life when I don't have the strength to give it away to you. Please take from me my life when I don't have the strength to give it away to you, Jesus. And how many times have I turned away? The number is the same as stars in the sky, but every time now I pray you do it tonight. Please take from me my life when I don't have the strength to give it away to you. Please take from me my life when I don't have the strength to give it away to you, Jesus. To give it away to you.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to feel, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first became. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy reigns, unending love. Yeah. satisfy me with your love, and all I have in you is more than enough.
Father, we thank you for Patricia's life. Father, we thank you for the way her life impacted so many people in this room. Father, we pray that as it's a reminder of how short life is, how fleeting life is, help us to be prepared for when our time comes. Father, I think of those that will continue on from here. Father, I think of the children. I think of Daryl. Father, we ask that in the coming days and weeks and months, when there's just times of pain, times of hurt, just because they're missing Pat so much. Father, I ask that you would comfort them in a special way. Just put your arms around them and comfort them during those times. And Father, I thank you for each one that came out here today to celebrate Pat's life. And Father, we ask that as they go back to their own homes, Father, that you would give us safety as we travel back and help us to live lives that are full like Pat's life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, guys. She wanted a party, so we got to turn it all out back. Have fun. Go away.
Sure.